Right into WDSU first warning weather, and it's about Milton first. Of course, it's still weakening. This is still a tremendous hurricane. Still a Category 2 hurricane at the 10 o'clock update. Wind still over 100 miles per hour. Again, at 105, that means there's higher gusts because those are an average wind speed at over 1 minute a time. Pressure's up to 960. We've got the movement east-northeast at 16. You can see this is still now a Category 1 as it emerges out into the Atlantic and still holding on to hurricane intensity, where previous forecast had to go into tropical storm status and then weakening from there. This is still going to skirt Orlando right on the cusp of being a Category 2 in some of the worst rain just north of there. So it was earlier when we had this making landfall at 7:30 our time, so that was just about 3 hours ago, and the worst of that with the rain was right through St. Petersburg and Tampa. Winds were 120, a major Category 3. And let me show you here in a little bit what that's done for the rainfall. Right now, this is real-time, high-res radar. Orlando's getting the worst of it. Lakeland getting the worst of it, at least with a heavy rainfall. But I'll show you the winds right now. Still winds 108 miles per hour. Still winds on the south side. We've seen upwards of over 100 miles per hour right now. Again, these are real-time, live detection of those winds, at least hurricane status. And what those strong winds have done have knocked out a ton of power. Hundreds of thousands without power. You add them all up, we're getting closer to a million plus people without power there right now. Rainfall rates easily 5, 6, 7 inches per hour. Recorded rainfall rates of 7 inches per hour in St. Petersburg, where actual rainfall that's been recorded 16 inches. Flash flood emergencies going on. Radar estimation shows maybe in some spots over 17 inches. And that was right on the forecast as I was showing you here even last night. So we still have a ways to go with this particular storm, but every hurricane and tropical system has its own identity. This one's going to go down as a tremendous tornado maker. Over 27 tornado reports, at least reports of tornadoes today, possibly dozens of them that fell. Look at the East Coast that had this from Palm Bay to Port St. Lucie, the 95 corridor, Cape Coral, and even Bradenton with tornado reports here today. So that's what it's going to go down as most likely. Still have flash flood emergencies. That's what this is right here, a flash flood emergency. Tampa area, St. Petersburg, flash flood warnings even up into Orlando right now. Here's the forecast. We still will not be done with this storm until we get to about midday tomorrow. Even the last edge branches and batches of storms still have to come through by that time. As I mentioned earlier, it's been completely different here. We've enjoyed some beautiful fall weather, and it was courtesy of that front that drove through to keep that storm south of us. Real-time temperatures 67 Bogalusa. It's still 80 here in the city. Dew points were up a little bit, but still pretty comfy. Now, take a look at our temperature forecast. That's really what it's all about. You're going to want a jacket tomorrow morning. North Shore, Franklinton, Hammond, Amite, Slidell, just to name a few. Even Houma, Galliano at 64, you might want a light jacket too. We got a sunny day, and there's a little bit of some stronger winds off the coast, so small craft advisory still in effect. Beware. And we still have some coastal flooding that's in effect too. That's with the high tide kicking into where those waters are brushing and winds are brushing all that water on shore. Could be 2 feet above some typical levels that are over the roadways or over land. High temperatures tomorrow, still pretty warm, 85, 86, maybe 87. But the low temperatures is a little cooler and drier air work in going into the weekend. 50s all the way down, Slidell 57. I got Houma down to 59, 67 here. And then we look at your forecast, still a ton of sunshine, a little bit cooler. Let's go 83, 84 into Friday. We're not going to stop there. 50s dropping into Galliano by Saturday morning as that little cooler air drives in. And if we extend out the forecast, you think it's nice now, or you're ready for some really crisp fall air? Next week by Monday into Tuesday, we're going to drop in an even stronger cold front. And look at what this is going to do to low temperatures by next Wednesday morning. Even here in the city, I got us getting down to 59, possibly flirting with some 40s by next Wednesday. So some might think about looking at that heat being tried to turn on. I know it sounds early, but I don't want you to be freezing out in those 40s North Shore. 7 day forecast, you look at those 80s continuing, slightly cooler, the crisp mornings in some cases, and then that big cool down as we get into next week.